Safe Berks on BCTV is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.
Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to Safe Berks on BCTV. On behalf of Safe Berks, we would like to thank Visions Federal Credit Union for sponsoring today's show. And my name is Jen Ebersole, and I'm the Director of Education and Outreach at Safe Berks. And Safe Berks provides a safe haven and ongoing support services for victims of domestic violence and sexual assault. And through our education and aware and systems advocacy programming, we promote more awareness and education in the prevention of sexual violence, domestic violence, and all forms of oppression. And today I'm really excited because so much of what we do at Safe Berks, as far as raising more awareness and preventing violence from occurring, it does happen through our education and outreach department, and that's why we're here today to really talk about an exciting program that we have called Camp Safe Berks, a teen alliance to end violence. And we're excited to be here today. And for those who are not aware of what Camp Safe Berks is, Camp Safe Berks is a free day camp available for all Berks County youth aged 13 to 17. And it's available during the summer. And what it does is it raises awareness and it promotes the forming of alliances of support and peace, and promoting peace and justice in our communities. And we accomplish this by focusing each day of camp on a different form of social oppression and the role that it plays in being really the root cause of violence in our society and how we can take charge to fight against these injustices in Berks County. Each day, we focus on a different form of oppression. And as you can see on the screen, they are basically formed as in the following way. The first day includes Youth Justice Day, and we explore the issue of adultism. Racial Justice Day, where we explore racism. Gender Justice Day, where we explore sexism. And LGBTQ+, where we explore heterosexism. And Economic Justice, and we explore classism. And during this time, campers engage in all kinds of discussions and group activities, and you know, really taking the form to start to understand what these different oppressions are and how they relate in the world around us, and really, you know, fostering adult allies and creating new friendships and taking the information that they've learned throughout the week back into their community to become social change agents. And I'm excited to have with me today several guests that participated in Camp Safe Berks, which, by the way, did just take place July 23rd through the 27th, right here on the beautiful campus of Albright College. And I'd like to introduce our guests today. So with me, we have Steve Onsman. He's the lead pastor at Calvary United Church of Christ, and he's also a Safe Berks board member. So welcome, Steve.
I'm here.
We also have Lily Lenowitz, who lives in Birdsboro, and you'll be entering the 12th grade this year. And she is going to be a senior at Twin Valley High School. We have Kayla Russell, who will be entering the 11th grade, and she is homeschooled in Exeter Township. And we have Amanda Russell, who will be entering the 8th grade, who is also homeschooled in Exeter Township. So thank you all so much for being with us today. And so if you don't mind, what I'd like to try to start out by saying is just want to introduce yourself, say a little bit about yourself and, you know, why you're excited to be here. So anybody can start.
I'm Lily. I'm 18. I'm a senior at Twin Valley High School. I'm excited to be here to promote a really fun and educational camp that I think is really beneficial for youth in our area.
Awesome. Hi, I'm Amanda Russell. I'm 13. I am homeschooled, and I'm really happy to tell people about Safe Berks Camp.
Hi, my name is Kayla Russell, and I'm a junior, and I'm glad that we are all able to be here to create more awareness for people to understand more about what Safe Berks is and what it is as a camp.
And I'm Steve Onsman. I'm not going to tell you what my age is, and I was I've been a pastor at Calvary United Church of Christ here in the city for a while, and very committed to social justice and all the issues around fairness and equality.
Great. Okay. So I just want to start out by asking a very general question to each of you. When you first learned about Camp Safe Berks, what was your first impression that you had, that maybe what you were expecting to get out of the experience? Not after the fact, but when you first learned about it, what were your expectations?
I was interested because I had never really heard of a program like this, especially in our area. One thing I was maybe a little worried about was maybe like a maturity gap since I was like the oldest, but I was very impressed by the level of maturity and social awareness of all the campers and adults.
Great. I didn't really know what to expect by going to Safe Berks Camp. I actually just thought that we were just going to like learn some new few things, but it was actually a really nice experience.
Great.
I was really excited, and it was very impactful because I feel like these are situations that people should be talking about that they don't really talk about in school or correctly on social media.
I've been involved with the camp for about, 8 or 9 years in different ways. And, one of the things that amazes me about this is that when I was in high school and even in college, nobody talked about these things. Nobody in my community talked about these things. And it's a challenge when you're a person like me who's sort of on the power side of every issue to recognize privilege. And so that's part of what really excites me is that you get to talk about what it means to have privilege, what it means to struggle to have it, and how you find fairness and all that. So that's, to me, that's why I got involved in the beginning, was because it just was an exciting way to see such maturity in kids when I was so far behind at this age on these things.
Yeah, great. Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody, for those wonderful answers. So I mentioned that Camp Safe Berks, it's a teen alliance to end violence. And one of the main objectives is to begin this process of forming a teen and adult alliance together so that together we can work in and amongst each other to help reduce some of these social injustices. And Steve, I know you mentioned, we are, as adults, are powerful allies in
right.
this process.
Right.
You've been involved for a number of years, which we are so thankful for. In your thought process, in your meaning, what does it mean to be an adult ally, especially after you've participated now for so many years?
I think back as a teenager, I didn't have allies in this way. I mean, we were basically told what to do, and we did it. I saw how my friends of color, of different religions, were treated. I saw all of these things going on, but was powerless to do anything about it. And so for me, to have, to be an adult and to be able to not tell people what to think or how to think, but be part of the process, is a really important thing. I wish more adults would think about that, because it's not that you give everything over, right? There's still things that I know as an adult that teenagers don't. I mean, it's still how it is. There's still things that people older than me don't know that I don't know. We can all learn from each other and be supportive. And I learned from the folks in the camp, and I hope they learn from the adults that were part of it. And we just need to be supportive, because oftentimes kids don't have a voice.
And so much of what it is about camp is to make sure that they have a voice, right?
Right.
And hopefully we accomplish that with camp this year. And the power, we do have a couple of pictures that show, just how the adults work together as allies. And Steve, I'm going to ask you another question as some of these photos come up. Throughout the week, you did work closely with these students. What was your biggest takeaway from any of the campers or the camp this year?
Well, I think the biggest takeaway, I've always known it, but you see it in action, is that even when you are like me, when you have privilege, It doesn't mean people don't have, without privilege, don't have authority or power. So that they can speak for themselves and they can be advocates for themselves as well. But the biggest takeaway was just, again, how mature in these areas the campers were, how they understood that there's systemic issues that, again, people still are trying to say they don't exist. But to be able to say that racism is a real thing. Mm-hmm. And it's not that if you're white, you're a racist. It means that you're part of a system, you benefit from a system that lifts up whiteness and puts down people of color. So when you get that concept and you get away from the whole guilt thing or the personal aspect of it, they understand that in ways that were surprising to me and enlightening.
Yeah, it was really impressive to see just how much I learned so much from everybody at camp, and that's part of this process. We learn from each other, and we are there to support each other throughout this process to really make a change in our lot, in the communities we live in, our schools, and you know, again, really the goal is to just be in a more peaceful community that we live, work, and play in. So that's great. Thank you so much, Steve. So I'm going to turn to Lily. Lily, I know you were really excited to participate in camp. In fact, you had reached out even before we had scheduled camp, which we were so excited about. So you were officially the first person on the list, which we were happy about. But would you mind sharing with us a little bit about what your experience was like? And, you know, if it was any different than what you were first expecting it to be?
Mm-hmm. I had a really good experience at camp. It was a week of education with like-minded individuals, which is something that I think a lot of people don't always get at their school or in their own communities, so that was nice. Like I said earlier, I was kind of like expecting maybe like a maturity gap, but I was so impressed by like the level of maturity and social awareness of campers as young as like 13 or 14 years old, so I was very impressed by that.
Great, thank you. And then as far as one thing that you learned from camp that you previously weren't aware of, maybe it was something about yourself or just a particular topic that we covered, what was something that you learned that you previously didn't know about yourself or about an issue?
The one thing that really sticks in my mind was on Gender Justice Day when we talked about how women do 70% of the world's work and only earn 10% of the world's wages and own 1% of the world's property. That's crazy.
It's pretty astounding, isn't it? Makes you want to do something about that, right?
Definitely.
Awesome. That's great. Thank you so much. All righty. Okay, so we're going to turn things over to Kayla. Okay, so every day we had pretty much jam-packed with all kinds of activities and discussions and, of course, rec time, free time, things like that. You know, there was a lot of discussion that occurred and important topics that covered these, you know, imbalances of power that Steve alluded to and really how we can start to uncover what that looks like and understand it a little bit better and to figure out how we can reduce some of the violence in and amongst these communities. You know, so what day in particular, was there one day over another that really stuck out to you and, you know, was the most impactful to you and why it was the most impactful to you?
I feel like Racism Day was very impactful to me because of the fact of people don't really understand that racism is a real thing, or people don't understand the fact of, oh, this is racism, this makes me racist. But I feel like that's something that people try to foreshadow in a way and don't really talk about that much because people would otherwise discard it and rather not talk about it because it's just not something that people would want to hear. It's not something happy.
Right, but it's an important issue that people really need to understand and talk a little bit more about so that we can get past those differences. Yeah, that's great. And then as far as, you know, your favorite part about camp, was there one favorite part, part of the day or an activity that we did? Maybe it was relevant to one of the topics we covered. Was there a favorite part of your day during camp?
I liked that after every day we would, for sexism, racism, heteroism day, gender youth justice day, I appreciated that we would go up to our allies and explain certain things to them and have them understand and perceive what, oh, this is a situation that my friend is going through. I really want to be an ally and be able to support them with that situation.
Is that something that you find a lot in today's society, adults that are willing to really listen and help you figure out how to do things differently?
I feel like that's very important, that adults should be able to listen, because otherwise determining the age gap and not understanding, oh, these are just kids.
Great. Okay. Thank you. All righty. Okay, so I guess we'll turn now our focus to Amanda. Hello. Yeah. Okay, so some of the topics that we discussed are, you know, obviously very heavy, and which was why we felt it was really important to make sure we're incorporating a lot of breaks and recreational time. Was there a particular activity or something that we did in during that downtime that you found to be the most, or any takeaways that you, you know, really stuck out in your mind that was most fun throughout the week, or something that we did that was particularly in your mind helpful to have part of that process?
Well, I actually really enjoyed when we would like sit in our groups and everything and communicate with each other and talk about what we learned during today, and it was really helpful.
That's great. Did you learn anything new about yourself that you didn't previously know?
Well, I learned that I can count on my allies to talk to them and stuff like that. And I learned that we need to like help each other when they need help and stuff.
That's great. Thank you so much. Okay, so I'm going to ask a question. This is going to be for all of our campers, so feel free to answer whomever you would like to. So since leaving camp, we know that, you know, obviously when you're empowered, and along with, you know, your adult allies, you really do become the change agents that you want to see, that we all want to see in Berks County to make a difference against some of these issues. So what was something that you took away from camp that you really feel is going to, you're going to change or do differently in your community and how you interact with your friends and your peers? One thing, one takeaway from camp that you feel that you'll be doing differently.
I think I'll probably have try my best just to educate and be helpful in whatever situations I can.
That's great.
I would basically just talk like to people in my community and tell them about like the camp and everything, and about what I learned and how it's like a really important place.
Kind of like what they both said, educate people and have them understand that you can be an ally and you can be able to support people even if you're not going through the same thing that they're going through.
Great. Wonderful. So if you were explaining to someone about camp and maybe why they should attend, what would you say to them?
I'd say it's a week that's full of both fun and education, and it's just a fun week with like-minded individuals, and you forge good relationships with adults and other campers alike.
Great.
I would say that the camp is exciting, fun. You might not know what you're doing sometimes, but you would get to learn a lot that you didn't really know before, and it's a really good thing.
Great.
Would tell people, why wouldn't you go? It's so much fun, and you learn so much information and how to be an ally.
And how to be an ally. That's great. Thank you so much. Okay. All righty. So, Steve, as a volunteer and returning volunteer for many years, for those sitting at home wondering whether or not Camp Safe Berks might be something to volunteer their time for, if it's a worthwhile time commitment, what would you say to them?
It's exhausting, but fun and just very invigorating. And you know, I think the other thing is that when you were talking about racism, thinking about this weekend being the year since Charlottesville, and how there are so many people in this country who think that being a Nazi or a white supremacist, or being part of the Klan, is at least acceptable, if not appropriate. These kinds of things are so important, and so if you have a mind to help really change the world one kid at a time and one adult at a time, this is a way to do that. It's a big commitment. There are other ways you can do that. Our church donates to provide for one camper to attend. I think it's $300 or something, allows a camper to be there. Churches can do that. Synagogues, individuals can do that. And it helps Save Berks do it because it's all about violence and getting violence under control and getting, hopefully, rid of it.
Okay. And so, again, Steve, thank you so much for volunteering your time and making a commitment, because it is a big commitment. I mentioned earlier that camp would not be available to anyone for free had it not been for our wonderful supporters and sponsors. And I do just want to mention a few. Like I mentioned, or like Steve mentioned, his church did provide monetary donations, as did so many other very, very gracious individuals throughout Berks County. We also had several local businesses support us through a number of different ways. Breaking the Cycle Foundation, the Junior League of Reading, Berks Intercultural Alliance, Reading Metro Taxi Cab, Weiss Markets in Wyomissing, Redner's Warehouses Incorporated, Pepperidge Farm, Diefenbach's Potato Chips, Unique Pretzels, Tom Sturgis Pretzels, and Berks Foods. And like I said, many other individuals who were so gracious in their donations to help us so that we can bring Camp Safe Berks to Berks County for free. Everything is 100% free, meals included. So it's been a really wonderful experience. Camp Safe Berks does go beyond the week at camp. We will be reconvening the youth throughout the year to participate in reunions and talking amongst themselves to figure out how they can go back into their community and really make an impact for change in the future. And so just before we wrap up, I want to ask if any of our campers and Steve have any lasting thoughts that you might want to share with the viewers about any of your perceptions related to camp.
Just go to Safe Berks Camp and you'll have a fun time participating and also learning something new.
Awesome, Kayla.
You don't know what you're missing out, so you should go.
Great. Anyone else? Okay. All right. All right. Well, I would like to thank Steve and Lily and Kayla and Amanda for coming today and joining in our show today. We had a phenomenal time, and I look forward to working with everyone in the future. And if you or someone you know needs help, if they are a victim of domestic violence or sexual assault, please have them contact our 24-hour free hotline at 844-789-SAFE or text Safe Berks at 20121. And also, please visit our website at www.safeberks.org to learn about any different programs that we might and activities coming up. And also for Camp Safe Berks 2019, by the end of the year, we will be having more information coming out about that. So I invite you to visit our website to learn more. And I thank you for joining us today and tuning in, and we will see you next month.
Safe Berks on BCTV is supported by Visions Federal Credit Union.